This video is for the 7th grade tech blog assignment 3. First, in a new tab, you're going to open up 3x3 grid and Google Drive. And then from here, what you're going to do is you're going to click up at the top where it says Search Drive and type in Finding Reliable Websites. And you're going to click on the document that appears with your name and your partner's name. Then from here, what you're going to do is you're going to scroll down to where it says Website Number 2. And you're going to click on the website that appears and then click on the blue link that appears underneath it. And from here, what that's going to do is it's going to bring you to your website about your second topic. So what you want to do is just kind of read through and find a good quote that you'll be able to use in your blog post. So anyway, what we'll do next is we'll go ahead and click back over to Google Drive. And then from here, you're going to open up your blog post. So you're just going to click up at the top where it says Search Drive. In my case, mine is in a document called Blog Posts. So I can just go ahead and click on that in order to open up my blog posts. And so basically what I want to do here is add a new blog post in this document. So you want to include something similar to what we see here, where we've got a title. And then you want to start telling, you know, many people think they can decide who can use and sell their Instagram photos. So kind of just give like a little bit of background. And then you're going to say, according to the author in the year. So in this case, it was Jessica Contreras and it was written in 2015. And then this right here is the quote that I'm going to copy and paste. So it says, basically, if someone copies your Instagram to account of their own, the company can do something about it. So I'm just going to copy those couple of sentences by hitting Control C. And then you go back over to your blog posts. And so then you've got quotation marks, and that's the same quote right there that I copied, starting with the word if there. And then what you're going to do, once you have that quote, notice it's in quotation marks, you're going to give your own opinion about the topic. So once you have all of those things, what you're going to do is you're going to click and drag to highlight your entire post and hit Control C on your keyboard. Then from here, you're going to open up a new tab, and in the new tab, you're going to go to Weebly.com. Then from here, click on Login. And click on G plus login. Then from here, click on edit site. Next, what you're going to do is you're going to see if you have any drafts from last class. You may or you may not. The way you'll know is if you see drafts 1 at the bottom. So if you don't see it, you can skip this part. But anyway, you would click drafts, click the name of the draft, and then click on post up at the top. But you want to make sure, obviously, that you have everything that you need before you post it. So then click post. Anyway, so, and then you can X out. But anyway, so if you don't have that draft, so you don't have to worry about that part. What you're going to do is you're going to click new post down at the bottom. And then from here, where you see post title, you're just going to put in a quick title. So something like, can people sell your Instagram photos? And then from here, what you would do is you would add in a text box. And it's right up here, top left corner. So click and drag the text box. And then you would click up where it says, click here to edit. And then hit Control V on your keyboard, and that's going to paste your blog post. Next, what you're going to do is click back over to the article that you used. You're going to click the URL to highlight it, hit Control C on your keyboard. And next, we're going to open up a new tab so that we can do an EasyBib citation. So you're going to go to EasyBib.com, and then from here, what you're going to do is you're going to click on I only want to create citations. And then from here, what you're going to do is hit Control V on your keyboard to paste the URL and then click Cite. And then next, what you'll do is click on Cite. at the bottom of the page, or almost at the bottom. And then from here, what you want to do is scroll down, click on continue. And then from here, what you'll do is make sure all the information is filled in. In this case, it didn't fill in the author's name. So if we look at the article, the author's name is typically going to be at the top. It's Jessica Contreras, so we're just going to click back over to EasyBib, enter in that information. So you want to enter in anything that comes up as blank. And so, unfortunately, it doesn't always come up with everything filled in. So in this case, now everything's filled in. We're going to click on Complete Citation. And sometimes this might happen. I'm just going to click View a Sponsored Message and just say you're under 13. Proceed to activity, no ads available, close. So then here what you're going to do is scroll down and you're going to see your citation right here, about halfway down. You're going to click on the three dots, click on copy to clipboard. Then you'll click back over to Weebly. And what you're going to do is underneath your paragraph, you're going to click on work, or you're going to type works cited, and then hit enter, and then control V on your keyboard to paste the citation. And so then what you're going to do next is click on post, and then hit the X. And then you're going to add categories to your posts. So what you're going to do is click on the post that you just added, then click on post options. From here, click add categories. And you're just gonna type in Instagram, if it's about Instagram. You wanna make your categories just like one or two words, so Instagram. And then click on update. And then I'm gonna do the same thing with my my other posts. So I'm going to scroll down and click on this post right here, post options, add categories. This one's also about Instagram, so I don't need to add a new category. I can just click Instagram and then click update at the top. And then finally, you can just go ahead and exit out of it. And then the last one we're going to do is the about us post. If you haven't already added a category, click about us. And then post options, we'll just call this one about. So click on add categories and type in about, and then you'll choose that new category that we just added and click on update. And that's it.